For latest astrology videos, subscribe AstroEdify channel and press this bell icon to get notified when a new video goes live.
Hello everybody, welcome to AstroEdify. Today we are going to discuss that what happens when moon is in the sign of Aries in anyone's horoscope. So let's start the video. If you want to book a consultation for yourself from me, you can go on this website. The link is given in the description section. So today we are going to start our new series on moon in various zodiac signs. So first is moon in Aries. What happens when moon is in Aries in anyone's horoscope? First thing we are going to discuss is about moon. See, moon is the most important planet in astrology. Of all the nine planets, moon is the most important one. Moon, Lagna Lord and the Lagna together, they form the base of the horoscope. They are the foundation, they are the pillars. If moon gets weak, then now the strength, the overall strength of the horoscope reduces. And moon is the only planet which has the capability to negate all the good yogas, all the raj yogas. It can create raj bhang yoga, means no result of your raj yoga if moon is bad. So moon is the main planet for that, which helps in fructification of any yoga, whether good or bad, it is moon always. So moon is very, very important. And one of the simplest reason to assume is that moon is your mind. Moon is your thinking and thought process, your main emotions, feelings, how you think, what you think is controlled by moon. So if your mind is not proper, if your mind is unstable, how can you think that you are going to comprehend in daily tasks? How can you think that you are going to perform well in your career or perform well in maintaining your relationships? It cannot happen because moon is controlling everything in your brain here. So moon is very, very important. Moon is a watery planet, so it controls our water content in the body. The 65% of the water in the body is controlled by moon. Moon, and it controls everything, whether it is your emotions, your feelings, your hormones, your whole blood flow is controlled by moon. Everything which comes under the water content. Okay, so moon is very, very important planet. Apart from this, moon also represent arts, imagination, creativity, travels. It is the natural significator for mother, your childhood. Your moral values are seen through moon. Your character is seen through moon because moon is your mind. How you are thinking defines your character. How you are thinking defines your nature as a person. How you are thinking defines your identity as a person. So moon is very, very important. So moon defines you as a person in total. And not only the moon, but also your sun as well as the Lagna and the Lagna Lord. All of them together form you as an individual. So moon, among these four other entities, moon is one of the entities which is defining you as a person. So moon is very important. Now come to the Aries. What is Aries zodiac sign? See, Aries is a zodiac sign ruled by Mars and it is a fiery sign. Okay, and naturally, according to Kalpurush Kundali, it is the natural zodiac sign of the first house. So Aries represents fire within our body. So it controls your energy, stamina, physical strength, bodily strength, dedication, willpower, aggression, anger, impulsiveness, your confidence or overconfidence is seen through Aries. Your dominant attitude is seen through Aries. It represents leadership qualities, boldness, firmness. It also shows your self-respect. Okay. It is a sign which is full of courage and adventure because Mars is like that. Okay, then sports can be seen with this. Okay, with the Aries zodiac sign, it controls science and technology as well. So when moon is in Aries, we have to see what results can it give. And see, moon is the most sensitive planet. Whether it is with any planet in any zodiac sign in any house, moon and Mercury are the two main planets which are highly sensitive. If they are coming in contact with the other planets by aspect or by conjunction or in any zodiac sign, moon is going to exhibit all the qualities of the environment in which it is. So moon is very whenever you are assessing the moon of any person, it means that you are doing the most difficult task in astrology. You are assessing the person's mindset, okay, which is highly complicated, and yet it is very difficult for highly experienced and expert astrologers to conclude on this part, because you cannot define the person just by looking at the moon. You can, but the interpretation, that takes a lot of experience. So whenever we are going to see that how moon is, you have to check everything. Means you have to see all the things which are impacting the moon. So everyone will give a one or two flavors to the result of the moon now. So now let's talk about moon in Aries. Now first thing which we see here is that moon when is in Aries, it means your mind is in Aries. So you are going to think like Mars. Okay, Aries is ruled by Mars. So Martian qualities enhance in the mindset. What it shows that now person will be very energetic in mindset. Okay, person will be very energetic. He will be full of stamina. That dedication will be there. Boldness will be there in attitude. Firm attitude can be seen with this, because Aries is what? Firmness. But the thing here is that Aries is a movable sign. So problem here is in making the decisions properly. Because Aries represent rashness and impulsiveness in our attitude. So moon in Aries can show that the person could be very impulsive in making the decisions, rash in making the decisions. However, he is going to be firm on his decision, but the decision is not going to be taken on with patience. Okay, that is the problem here. So finally, that depends where? On the placement of Mars and Sun. Because they control your decision making ability. So if Mars is supporting the moon, then it is good that now person will be able to take proper decisions. However, they are going to be impulsive, but yet they are going to be right. But if Mars is badly placed, then decisions will always be wrong. And if you are going to take them in impulsive manner, then they are definitely going to turn out wrong. So boldness and firmness could be a good thing, but impulsive decision making is not a very promising thing to be seen here. Next thing is that here moon is your mind, so Aries is having a direct impact on that. So it is going to give you a strong willpower and dedication. Mars must be good. If Mars is bad, this will not happen at all. Then it will turn out into a total procrastination scenario, because Mars is your energy within the body. Sun is your energy within the body. If Sun and Mars are going down, then moon cannot help. It will be like a situation that from inside you want to do a lot of things, but when it comes to actually do the thing, you take a step back. That is the problem now. So you have to see Mars and Sun if you want to assess the dedication and willpower of any person. Okay, moon placement here just shows that okay, it is going to be a strong will and dedication in the mind, that you are going to be ambitious, you are going to think that okay, I want this, I will do this, but you have to check Mars and Sun for that, okay, in order to actually transform your thoughts into reality. Next thing is that it also makes person quite independent in attitude. However, there will be stubbornness also, because Aries and Mars is what? Your stubbornness, your firmness towards anything. These people love dominance also, quite dominant attitude. Next thing is that Mars and Aries are same, so it makes person quite action oriented, persistent, gives competitive and fighting spirit. Until and unless they are not going to achieve what they want, they are not going to stop. They never back down. This is a good quality which we can see. Persistence is there. However, we can see impatience, means if they are trying for something, they want the results to be very immediate in nature. But if they are persistent, they get the results. Only thing is that frustration happens when they do not get the results early. They want the results very immediately. If they take time, they feel frustrated and irritated and angry sometimes also. So action oriented is a good thing. Persistent attitude, very good thing. Competitive and fighting spirit can be seen here, because Mars and Aries, same thing, and also makes the person quite ambitious in nature. Okay. Next thing is that the person will be having risk-taking ability, means they will be courageous enough to do the things. And however, if Mars is not strongly placed, or even if it is, let's say Mars is strongly placed, then too they will have anger and aggression and impulsiveness high in their mind, high in their body. So that is why I said that they want things very immediately. So that is the thing. If we keep this thing apart, then this going to be a good trait now, that they are going to utilize their anger and aggression for a positive thing, to achieve a good thing in life. However, it makes person quite angry sometimes. These people lose their cool very often. And if especially Moon is sitting with Mars, or Moon is getting combust with Sun, you can definitely see this. Always with a short temper people, okay? So anger, aggression, impulsiveness quite high in the body. Then next thing is that confidence is a key to these people. These people have a lot of confidence, but you have to see that if Mars and Sun are very, very powerful, then it can turn into overconfidence, and sometimes ego also gets inflated. However, self-respect for these people is on a top priority. Very, very important. Self-respect is very important for them, because Aries is what? First house zodiac, and first is house is you yourself as a person, your self-respect in the society. Okay, so that is the thing which we can see. Next thing here is that Mars is a planet which is defines logic and science. So Aries is also the same thing. When Moon is in Aries, it gives scientific temper and logical attitude to the person. Okay, and it makes person quite rational in approach. Next thing is that these people will be more practical due to this nature. So more practical attitude will be there and less emotional. Moon is your emotions, but when it is in Aries, which is fire, so now Moon gets subside, because I said Moon is highly sensitive. It is going to exhibit all the qualities in which zodiac sign it is sitting and with the planets with which it is sitting. So emotions take a back seat now. Practicality comes to the front. And now these people will have a warlike nature, that they take everything as a task. Okay. And they have that thinking process that I have to conquer this. Okay. So that is a warlike nature, because Aries is what? War. Mars is what? God of war. So here that attitude will be there, that I am going to take everything as a task to conquer. Everything as a task to conquer. I have to conquer it. That kind of mindset Moon provides here to the person. So warlike nature can be seen, and these people have such kind of attitude that they think Moon makes them think that this anything which you are going to get in life, you are going to get it only on the basis of your efforts, only on the basis of your labor and hard work and dedication. And the all of these things which you are putting, you are working day and night, you are going to get the result. You are not going to get the result just by being optimistic. Optimism is going to be there, confidence is going to be there, but these people are more action oriented. They believe in doing actions. They do not believe in just by sitting idle and having a lot of optimism in mind. No, they believe that if you want things to happen on ground and transform them into realities, you will have to work. You cannot escape that. And Moon gives a thinking here that this whole world is a jungle, where in order to survive, you have to be the fittest person. So you have to grab the opportunities, and opportunities will also come when you are going to work hard from your side. This kind of attitude Moon provides here to the person. Next thing is that maturity here comes with age, because I said Moon is what? Moon is a sensitive planet, but Aries is a movable sign, and any movable sign is quite unstable. Okay, stability is quite less there. So maturity in attitude comes with age, with experiences. Initially they might have a lot of energy within them, they want to do a lot of things, but as the life teaches them, they understand. But if Mars is bad and Moon is afflicted, problem in learning from mistakes will be there. That is a quite a drawback for Moon in Aries. These people find a lot of problem in learning from past mistakes. Now the next thing is that you have to see the Moon in total. Okay, if Moon becomes afflicted, means it is with all the malefic planets, it is not in a good position in the Vamsha chart, then it can, and Moon is your mind and Aries is your brain and mind, okay, naturally. So it can show emotional imbalance, due to which mental ailments can happen. Any kind of mental problems can be seen with this particular placement if Moon gets afflicted. And Moon is highly vulnerable and sensitive planet. If Moon is well placed, very good. If Moon gets afflicted, these problems can happen. And for this, you have to see the combinations in other various divisional charts also, which we see for health. Okay, so that is going to be one thing. Then no control over your anger. Rage will be there, sudden rage, sudden anger, impulsiveness, loss of concentration can happen, and improper thinking, illogical thinking, that can happen. If Mars is well ill placed, if Mars is not well placed at all, if it Moon gets afflicted, then this kind of problems can be seen. Blood disorders can happen. Moon is your blood flow, Mars is your blood in the body. Okay, so that can also be seen with this particular placement. If Moon is afflicted, you must see the condition of Moon in total. Moon is your mother also, so we can also see that mother could be quite strict in approach in parenting and could be very aggressive. If Moon is afflicted by Mars or Saturn, then this can show that mother is going to be very strict, a disciplinarian kind of person, and sometimes could turn abusive to the person also. Whether physically or emotionally, she could be abusive to the person, especially in the childhood. But you have to see the condition of the other planets and the dashas. Okay, the dashas, how they are going. So then we can see that. So if Moon is not badly placed, Mars is not badly placed and Moon is not afflicted, then this can show mother is going to be strict. Mother is going to instill discipline in the person. Mother is going to provide that that nature to the person that you should never back down. Have confidence in yourself and stay no matter what. So that kind of quality can be seen within the mother herself as well as the child. So this is how we can see that what happens when Moon is in Aries in anyone's horoscope. Okay, and the last thing is that there are certain nakshatras, three nakshatras are there, Ashwini, Bharani and Kritika. I have made the videos on all the nakshatras. You can see those videos here in the card section. And for Ashwini, for Bharani, for Kritika, how Moon can provide the result, you can see in those videos. Okay, I have talked in a much more detailed version there. So this is what happens when Moon is in Aries in anyone's horoscope. So if you are new to my channel, subscribe below. For more, you can check on my website and Facebook page. Otherwise, we will meet in the next video. Till then, goodbye and thank you.